Hallelujah. Thank you for Resurrection Day. Praise God today. You can be thankful today. It's not about the outside. It's about the heart. It's about Jesus, too. Praise God. God bless each and every last one of you that's watching. Thank God, you know, for the blood. Thank you, Jesus, for Resurrection Day. Hallelujah. I want to pray right now before I start. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray for those that's watching. I pray that He will bless you, teach you, and lead you, and guide you. I pray He will protect you in every area of your life, and I pray that you will be strong in the Word, and do what's good, do what's right. So Jesus loves you, because you is somebody. I pray for every sickness right now, and I pray that you will be healed in Jesus' name. I rebuke every demon and every devil trying to hold you back and not want to get up and go to church and praise God. But I just pray for you to be healed in Jesus' name and get all the knowledge and understanding of the will of God and keep your faith and don't give up. In Jesus' name, God bless you and your family. In Jesus' name, amen. I just want to share with you, about true righteousness. It says, but I warn you unless you obey God better than the teacher of religious law and the Pharisees do. You can't enter the kingdom of heaven at all. It said the Pharisees were exacting and prescriptive in their attempt to follow their law. So how could Jesus reasonably call us to greater obedience than theirs? The Pharisees' wickedness was that they were content to obey the law outwardly without allowing God to change their heart or, you know, attitude. Jesus was saying, therefore, that the quality of our goodness should be greater than that of the Pharisees. They looked pious, but they were far from the kingdom of heaven. God judges our heart. As well as our deeds, for it is the heart that our real allegiance lies. Be just as concerned about your attitude that people don't see as about your actions that are seen by all. That's why I tell folks, you know, don't play church. You know, they get the, you know, playing, shouting like they so holy and everything. They don't even be real. You know, they're making all that noise and, you know, fake dance or whatever, just get attention or whatever the show they got on. But God look on the inside, you know, he knows all about it. But the people can see things, you know, they know what's real. You know, like I can tell what's real and what's not real, praise God. But you know, God don't look on the you know, the outside. He look at the heart, you know, and God don't like pretending, you know, God ain't gonna tell you well, I just think about waking you up, you know, in the morning, I may wake you up and I may not, you know. He's not going to pretend, he's not going to play, you know. You're here for his purpose, you're here for a reason. You know, God's not going to play, he's not going to pretend, because he's real, and he loves us all, he loves you too. And he wants you to do what's right, you know, keep it real, and be righteous in him, and trust him. Also, you can read that in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 20. You know, and, you know, it says, take care, you know, don't do your good deeds publicly to be admired, because then you will lose the reward from your Father in heaven. You know, when you give a gift to someone in need, don't shout about it, as the hypocrites do, blowing trumpet in the synagogues, in the streets, to call attention to their acts of charity. I assure you, they have received all the reward they will ever get. But when you give to someone, don't tell your left hand what your right hand is doing. Give your gift in secret, and your Father, who knows all secrets, will reward you. Praise God. And that's in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 1 through 4. You know, I just thank God it's not no secret what he can do. You know I live in the light, I don't live in the dark. You know, and, you know, it's just a blessing, you know, that God showed me. You know what he all that he has for me, and I know he has more for me, you know, and I know he has more for you to do, praise God. But until next time, I want each and every one of you to be blessed on this Resurrection Day. And about, it's not about the clothes, not about what you have on, not about what you wear, it's about the heart, it's about Jesus and what he wants you to do. And God bless you all, and God keep you, praise God. You know, I got my praise on, hallelujah, this evening, praise God. I mean, I got it early this morning, praise God. I already been to the building, bow for the Lord. You know, awesome, awesome word, praise God. And I just pray that you had a blessed day, blessed evening, and so on. I just hope that you have a blessed upcoming week. In Jesus' name, until next time, take care, be good, love one another, keep your faith, be patient. I'll see you later. Until next time, God love you. So do I. Be good.